Welcome to the Lightspeed Restaurant Getting Started video guide for K-Series. I'm Vinny and I'm here to help you manage your tax settings. I'll explain the basic framework behind setting up taxes, show you how to create and edit taxes in the back office, and help you assign tax profiles to the accounting groups that contain your items. This is all necessary to ensure you collect the correct amount of tax from your customers on every transaction. If you've already started setting up your taxes in the back office welcome wizard, this is a great time to check your work and learn how to make adjustments in the future. First, let's talk about how taxes are structured in Lightspeed. There are tax profiles, which contain a set of tax rules. Tax rules tell Lightspeed Restaurant what taxes to apply and when to apply them. Here, taxes are the individual tax percentages that apply according to your local regulations. For example, a 10% sales tax or a 5% tax on alcoholic drinks. So for instance, you could create one tax profile with a tax rule that applies a general sales tax to all orders. And you could create a separate profile with two tax rules to apply the sales tax and an alcohol tax to specific types of orders. If you're in North America, you'll have to manually set up your taxes and tax profiles. But in other regions, we handle it for you automatically when creating your account. If you have any questions about your local tax obligations, we recommend contacting a financial professional for advice. Your region will also determine if tax is included in your item pricing or added on top of it. But regardless of where you're located, you'll have to assign a tax profile to each of your accounting groups to set how each group of items will be taxed. Now that we've covered the basics, let's add some taxes and tax profiles in the back office. If you're outside of North America, skip to the next chapter of the video because these settings will already be configured for your account. Sign into the back office and in the sidebar click Configuration, Settings, and then Taxes. You'll only see this option if you're located in North America. You can select an existing tax to edit it, but for this video, we'll create a new one by clicking Add New Tax. Please keep in mind that once created, taxes cannot be deleted. The required tax fields are Code, which is a unique label that identifies the tax, Description, or what the tax will be called on receipts and in reporting, and Rate, which is the tax percentage. Accounting reference and category only apply in certain circumstances, and you can learn more about these settings on our Help Center. Click Next to continue, review the details, and click Save New Tax to confirm. To add additional taxes, simply repeat these steps for each new tax. Now we'll add a tax profile. You'll need a separate tax profile for each tax or combination of taxes that you collect. For our example, let's create a tax profile that might apply to alcoholic drinks that require both a general sales tax and an alcohol tax. Click Tax Profiles in the navigation bar, then select New Tax Profile. We'll call it Alcoholic Drinks and put Sales plus Alcohol Tax in the description. Then, select a tax to begin setting up the profile's first tax rule. We'll start with the general sales tax that we created in the previous step. Next, we'll select an order profile from the dropdown to select the types of orders where these taxes apply. For a tax profile that might apply a general tax to all sales, we would select all for the order profile. But because we're creating a tax profile for alcoholic drinks served within our restaurant, we will select dine-in. You could also click Add Condition for more options that you can set on the tax rule. For instance, you might apply the rule based on receipt totals, sale dates, or quantity of items sold from an accounting group. We also want to apply the additional tax for alcohol to this tax profile. You can do that by clicking Add New Tax Rule and repeating the steps for the alcohol tax. In this example, the tax profile needs to apply both taxes, so we'll enable the Apply Next Matching Rule setting on the first tax rule. Without this, the profile will only apply the first applicable tax and stop checking for further taxes. To finish up, click Save to save your changes. Finally, let's assign tax profiles to an accounting group. This will apply the tax profile to all items within that accounting group. Click Menu Management and then Accounting Groups in the sidebar. You can check which menu items are in certain accounting groups by clicking the Items link next to it. To assign a tax profile, click Edit. Then, select the relevant tax profile and click Save. Repeat these steps for your other accounting groups to ensure all menu items are taxed correctly. Later on, when we show you how to process orders, you can test your tax setup and make adjustments if needed. And that's it for taxes. For more information, or if you have any questions, just visit our K-Series Help Center.